Oh, I shouldn't be making this video today. I just hate being sick. What's up guys, welcome back to another LumaFusion video. First, I want to apologize for my voice, but I really wanted to get this video out there. And as you saw in the topic, it's about motion tracking. Motion tracking in LumaFusion has been quite difficult. In Premiere Pro, you have some keyframes and you have some masking and you have some tracking options as well, which makes everything a lot easier. In LumaFusion, you don't have that. Let me show you an example. This is Premiere Pro going up and down and everywhere, and this is LumaFusion. It's about the same if you use this method, and you can see them at the same time here. The motion tracking is basically the same. It looks the same and it's just super awesome, but it takes a little bit of, I don't think it takes any longer time doing this in LumaFusion than it does in Premiere Pro. And the result is actually pretty similar. LumaFusion might be a better way to do this simply because, let's say for instance, it takes longer time to do it in Premiere Pro than it does in LumaFusion. So that's a plus for LumaFusion. And the result is the same, and you have less lag in, well, you have no lag in LumaFusion. And in Premiere Pro, if you don't have like a beast computer, you will experience lag and it will maybe slow down a little bit. As the more keyframes you make, the more things you have on your timeline, the slower Premiere Pro will be. So let's say for instance that in Premiere Pro, I add my footage and I add my color grading, some adjustment layers and some awesome effects, transitions and all that, it will start to lag. But if I do the same thing in LumaFusion, nothing will happen. It will still be the same. The render time is faster. I'm not gonna go into too deep into why the comparison of the two programs in this video. And here's two examples of the tracking. The one to the left is LumaFusion and the one to the right is Premiere Pro, and you can see that they are pretty close to each other. And since the movement is fast enough, it doesn't matter if you miss a keyframe or two, because it will still look super awesome and you can't tell the difference between LumaFusion and Premiere Pro. But now I feel that I need to sneeze and sneeze and sneeze, and I got my sneeze light up there, as I want to call it for today. Let's just jump into LumaFusion and start the tutorial. So before we start the tutorial, I just want to show you some examples. And here you can see that the motion tracking text is actually following my son pretty good. Let's move over to me, and you can see that the LumaFusion text on my fingertip is actually pretty accurate. And I believe that this is as close as you can get in LumaFusion compared to After Effects and Premiere Pro. In After Effects, it's a little bit easier than Premiere Pro, and LumaFusion should be harder. But as we take a look at my son running, you can also see that the text is bouncing with my son as well as he's running across. And you can see that for every step he takes, the text is going down with him as well. So now let's move over to my wife, and I put a watch text on her watch, and you can see how accurate this is. And you can also see there is some camera shakes inside of the footage as well. And even though we had some camera shakes, the watch text is following pretty good. So now let's go into LumaFusion and start the tutorial. So once we get into LumaFusion, we're gonna add the same footage as we used in the preview. And then we're gonna add this footage of me, and then we're just gonna simply delete the sound, and we're gonna add a text layer. And once we place the text layer above the main footage, we're gonna find the position where we want the motion track to begin. Then we're going to find the position where we want the motion tracking to end, and then make a cut to adjust the length of the text layer. And the next thing we do is go into edit on the text layer. You can delete your text here as I'm doing in this tutorial, and you can add a new one. Then we're gonna double tap on the text and we're gonna change the text to something else. And in this tutorial, we're gonna type tracking. Once we're done typing the text that we want, we can change the fonts and we can change the look of it with colors and shadows as well. You can also adjust the size, and I'm going to come back to that later in this video. So once we're done adjusting everything that there is to adjust and add and all that to the text, the next thing we do is to add a shape. And here is the key for making a proper motion tracking inside of LumaFusion. So we're gonna start by adding a shape and then change it to oval. Then we're gonna adjust the position of the shape and adjust the size as well. As we're gonna track my fingertip, we want the oval shape to be as close in size to my fingertip as possible. And here we can place the oval shape wherever you want to place it. We're just gonna take it in the middle of the text, underneath the text. Then we're gonna simply go into frame and fit, and we're gonna adjust the scale and zoom it out so it gets smaller. And then we're simply gonna go to the beginning of the clip and make a keyframe. Then we're gonna position this oval shape on my fingertip, and we're gonna go on and move forward in the timeline by tapping on this button and add another keyframe. We need to make sure that the tracking text and the oval shape is always following my fingertip. And this might take some time. I used around 3-4 minutes, I guess, to make this tracking. So I'm just gonna speed this up until we get to the end to show you the final result. You can also follow my example to see how I track this in LumaFusion. And now that we're done making the motion tracking inside of LumaFusion, we can go out to our timeline and we can play through and see what the final result looks like. Once you're done with the motion tracking and you're satisfied with the way it tracks, don't forget to go into edit once more and uncheck the oval shape or delete it, because you don't want this to be visible inside your final video. So that's how you make an awesome motion tracking inside of LumaFusion. Why does it always? That's it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and I hope you enjoyed this motion tracking the proper way inside of LumaFusion. So let me know in the comment section below what you think about LumaFusion versus Premiere Pro. Do you like those type of videos? And do you think that LumaFusion will at some point get to the level where Premiere Pro is not even needed. And also, if you're new to my channel and you haven't subscribed yet, please consider subscribing. It really helps me out a lot, especially when I'm sick. That's it for this video. I see you in the next one. Don't forget that notification bell, and I'll see you in the next. Peace out.